Hello there, it's Abhiram Nirola. I'm back here with my new video. Guys, the PSL vibes are fully on after those consecutive thrilling encounters is completion in yesterday's doubleheader. To continue the proceedings, we have a match between two of the most successful franchises in the history of PSL, Islamabad United and Quetta Gladiators. Let's preview. Do like, share and comment down below. Subscribe to my channel as well. On 11th of June 2021, the Sheikh Zayed Cricket Stadium Abu Dhabi is scheduled to host this clash. This venue is renowned to host low-scoring matches, or in fact, the matches involving 150 to 170 runs. The Abu Dhabi pitch was a lot better yesterday, hence it looks as though the curators and the PSL officials have finally drawn the conclusion that 160 plus runs encounters bring out the essence of T20 cricket. So do expect the pitch to remain flat and moist enough in order to allow the ball to reach the bat quite nicely even when the bowler hits the deck hard in that good length area with or without variations. An even pitch as such might help all kinds of T20 players. It's an evening match. Plus, teams tend to back their batters to chase totals on relatively quicker tracks nowadays, hence do expect the toss winning side to opt to field first, despite knowing the fact that the teams that have batted first so far in the current phase have had some sort of edge in every match. Quetta Gladiators, Zeke Weatherall, Usman Khan, Faf du Plessis, Sarfaraz Ahmed, captain and wicketkeeper, Azam Khan, Andre Russell, Mohammad Nawaz, Zach Wildermuth, Zahid Mahmood, Mohammad Hasnain, and Khurram Sehzal. To be honest, the replacement draft has actually benefited Quetta Gladiators the most in my view. They actually have got a brilliant opportunity to rise uphill as they have picked some effective players over big players to strengthen their side big time. Both Weatherall and Wildermuth are perfectly suited in the positions they might possibly play. Plus, they also have an informed Russell into the side to strengthen the power hitting resources. This is the best opportunity for QZ to register one of the great comebacks in the history of PSL, courtesy the performances from their perfectly suited combination. Islamabad United, Colin Munro, Usman Khawaja, Brandon King, Rohail Nazir wicketkeeper, Shadab Khan captain, Iftikhar Ahmed, Asif Ali, Fahim Ashraf, Hassan Ali, Mohammad Wasim Jr. and Fawad Ahmed. Sorry, but the combination doesn't really look fruitful to me. Yes, they potentially have got T20 specialists from number 1 to 11. They also have got quality all-rounders who are absolute match winners in at least one department. But too much of anything is harmful. Well, it looks as though the combination isn't that soothing. They need one of their overseas batters to bat like how Ronki used to for them in the previous seasons to make things look good for them. Will they have that stability from now on? Will their players get their actual numbers? Will Shadab stop displaying immaturity by not taking wrong gambles in wrong instances? We shall see. Barring the bowling experience factor and the win-loss ratio in PSL 6, QZ definitely look like the front runners in every other way, hence I'm backing QZ to win this clash. Take care.